Welcome to the world of numbers. Students, today in mental maths we are going to do page number 27, 28 and 29 of your rapid fire book. So students, today we are going to learn numbers from 201 till 999. And you already must be knowing numbers from 1 to 200. The numbers from 201 to 999, all the numbers are 3-digit numbers. So let's start discussing the questions. I will be taking one question from each part and the remaining you have to do as practice. So let's take the first question of the A part. As you can see here, children, there are blocks. Now we have to count the blocks and tell the total number of blocks. So as you can see, this yellow block, it is one block consists of 100 small boxes. So here you can see there are two boxes. So that means that the total number of blocks in these two blocks are 200. Okay, so it is 200 blocks. Now we can see some columns. How many columns are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 columns are there and each column has 10 small blocks. So it is a total of 50 blocks. So here it is total of 50 blocks and here you can find 8 blocks. So now the number that is shown by the blocks is 258. Okay, so this is 200. Here it is 50 and you have 8 here. So it is representing the number 258, which can be written as 2 at the hundreds place, 5 at the tens place and 8 at the ones place. So I hope you will be able to find the number for the remaining questions. Now moving to the B part, children. Here we have been given the number. We have to write the place value of each digit as well as we have to write the number name. Let's take one example. I'll do the first question for you. As you can see, this number is 561 with 1 at the ones place, 6 at the tens place and 5 at the hundreds place. And when we write the number name for this number, we will write it as 561. So the remaining you have to do it yourself. So let's move to page number 28 now. Here's the children, the topic is place value and expanded form. So A part, here you have been given a number and you have to write the place value of each digit. So let's take the first example. This number is 479 and now we will start telling the place value of each digit. So you find 9 at the ones place, which can be written as 9. 7 being at the tens place, you can write it as 70. And 4 being at the hundreds place will be written as 400. As you can see here, 4 being at the hundreds place will be written as 400. 7 at the tens place will be written as 70 and 9 at the ones place can be will be written as 9. Now children, coming to the B part, you can find that the each number is having some digits colored in blue. So you have to tell the place value of that digit. So let's take an example. Let me do this fourth question. You will find this number is 605 and we have to tell the place value of the digit 5. So 5 is at which place, children? It is at the ones place. So 5 ones, or you can simply write ones. Okay. Now moving to C part, we have been given the expanded form of a number and you have to find the number. Let's take the first one, 200s plus 1 1. So students, let's see which number it is. You have 200s. So that means 2 is at the hundreds place. And then you have 1 1. So that means 1 is at the 1s place. And we don't have any digits at the 10s place. So you can put a 0. That means this number we get is 201. So the number 200, 200s plus 1, 1 will be 201. So the expanded form is given in words. And we have found the number here. Now, deeper children, the number is given and you have to expand it. Expand means you have to write the place value of each digit in the given number. Okay, so let's see the first question. 248 is the number. And when we expand it, how can we write? As you know, 2 is at the hundreds place. So it will be written as 200, which is 200. And 4 is at the tens place, can be written as 40. And 8 is at the ones place, so you will write the number as itself. So 200 plus 40 plus 8 is the expanded form for the given number 248. Similarly, children, you can solve the remaining questions. Now, coming to page number 29, students, we have the topic comparing and ordering. Now, what is comparing, students? When you are given a set of numbers, you have to find out either greatest number or smallest numbers. Okay? Among the given set of numbers. So, let's take an example. If you see A part first question, you find three numbers given. 480, 408 and 804. And now you have to find out which is the greatest number, which means which is the biggest number. So you know that 804 is the greatest number and we could find it out. How could you find it? Because you can see, we will see the highest place and all the three numbers are having, here you find 4 at the hundreds place. Again, 4 is there at the hundreds place. But in this number, you have 8 at the hundreds place. So, 804 is the biggest number because 8 is a bigger number. So, you have to put a circle on the greatest number. Now, B part children, it is here, we have to find the smallest number. Now, you can see this example number 1. Three numbers are given and you have to put a circle on the smallest number. So the numbers given are 969, 696 and 789. So which is the smallest number, children? So let's compare the highest place of the three numbers. Here you have 9, here it is 6 and here it is 7. So 6 is the smallest number. So this number, 696, is the smallest number. Coming to C part, students, you have to write increasing order. So increasing order or ascending order means arranging the numbers from the smallest number to the greatest or the biggest number. You have a set of numbers given which are not in any order. Let's see the numbers: 678, 768, 867 and 687. Now let's arrange it in the increasing order. So can you tell me, children, which is the smallest among these numbers? Yes, it is 678. Then bigger to it will be 687. Still bigger is 768. And the biggest number is 867. So now we have arranged the numbers in increasing or ascending order. Now let's move to the decreasing order. Decreasing order, children, is just the opposite. So here now we have to arrange the numbers from the biggest to the smallest number. So now let's see which are the numbers given. Let's do the first question. 414, 844, 353 and 992. As you can see, all these numbers, when we see the number at the highest place, which is hundreds place, you find here 4, 8, 3, 9. So, which is the biggest number here? It is 992. So now we will write it first. Smaller than 992 is 844. Still smaller is 414. And the smallest number is 353. So now we have arranged the numbers in the decreasing order, that is from the biggest number to the smallest number. So students, here I have completed the explanation of page number 27, 28 and 29. You have to complete these pages in the book. Thank you.